This video presents how to edit railing nodes and segments in ARCHICAD. The railing reference line is a polyline, which can be edited using pet palette commands. The pet palette is available for both railing nodes and segments. If you click a railing node, the appearing pet palette contains two rows. The top row contains commands for the editing of the railing reference line geometry, while the bottom row contains commands familiar from pet palettes of other element types. Please note that these pet palette commands are available for user-created nodes, as well as nodes automatically created by ARCHICAD. By using the Move Node command, you can move the railing node to another position. If you move an associative end node so it no longer falls on a node of a possible host element, the node will be converted to a static railing node as indicated by its square-shaped hotspot. As a result, if the railing node adjacent to the modified end node is an automatic associative node, it will be converted to a user-created associative node as indicated by its round dot-shaped hotspots. If the railing node adjacent to the modified end node is a relative node, it will be removed since relative nodes can exist only between two user-created railing nodes. Relative nodes are discussed in greater detail later in this clip. If you move the end node to another node of its host element, automatic associative nodes may be added to or removed from the railing reference line. If you move an intermediate associative railing node, be it user-created or automatic, so it does not fall on a node of a possible host element, the node will be converted to a relative node as indicated by its small square-shaped hotspot. If it falls on a node of a possible host element, it will stay or become a user-created associative node. If you move a static node, it will stay static, unless you move it onto a node of a possible host, in which case it's converted to a user-created associative node. If you move a relative node, it will stay relative. Unless you move it onto a node of a possible host, in which case it's converted to a user-created associative node. If you move an automatic associative node, adjacent automatic associative nodes will be converted to user-created associative nodes as indicated by their dot-shaped hotspot. By using the fillet or chamfer command, you can fillet or chamfer corners of the railing reference line at the clicked node. The operation may be performed on the clicked node only, or on all corners of the railing reference line. In such cases, new nodes are created at the defined distance from the modified corner node. These new railing nodes will be static nodes. If you click an associative railing node, the pet palette will contain the railing node type command. Activating it will take you to a dialog in which you can convert it to a static node. The change can be applied to either the clicked node or all nodes where applicable. As a result, adjacent automatic associative nodes will be converted to user-created associative nodes. For railing end nodes, there's one additional pet palette command available, the Continue Railing command. If you activate it, you can continue drawing the railing reference line starting from the clicked node. If you click a railing reference line segment, you will see that the appearing pet palette contains two rows. Again, the top row contains commands for editing railing reference line segments, while the bottom row contains commands familiar from the pet palettes of other element types. By using the Insert Node command, you can place a new railing node into the railing reference line. The type of railing node created depends on where the new node is created, on a host node or not, and whether both its adjacent railing nodes are associative. If the newly created node falls on a node of a possible host element, a user-created associative railing node is created. If the newly created node does not fall on a node of a possible host element, and at least one of its adjacent railing nodes is static, the railing node created will also be static. If the newly created node does not fall on a node of a possible host element, and both its adjacent railing nodes are associative nodes, either user-created or automatic, a so-called relative node is created, as indicated by its small square-shaped hotspot. This hotspot is smaller than the square-shaped hotspot marking static nodes. Automatic railing nodes adjacent to the modified node will be converted to user-created associative nodes, as indicated by their round dot-shaped hotspots. Relative nodes are called relative because they keep their relative position between those two railing nodes. If the relative node is located on the segment connecting the two adjacent nodes, the relative node will keep its relative position on that segment. For example, if the relative node is at 1/3 of the segment length from one of the adjacent nodes, it will keep that position when either of those nodes is moved. If the relative node is offset from the segment connecting the two adjacent nodes, it will keep its relative position on that segment, plus the perpendicular absolute distance it is offset from that segment. Continuing with the previous example, if the relative node is offset 1 meter from the 1/3 connecting segment length position, it will keep this relative position when either of those nodes is moved. The next two pet palette commands convert a straight railing reference line segment into a curved segment. Both the curve edge and the edit segment using tangent commands work as they do when editing other polygonal element types. If an associative railing segment is curved so it no longer lies on a segment of its host element, the segment will become static, and its geometry does not update when its corresponding host element segment is modified. The last railing segment type command of the pet palette lets you modify the segment type of the clicked railing segment. The command only appears for associative railing segments. These are segments that fall between user-created or automatic nodes, or for static segments between user-created associative nodes. If the segment is associative, you can change it to static. This means that if the corresponding segment of its host element is changed, the railing segment will not change it. If the railing contains automatic associative nodes, these will be deleted and the static segment will be generated between the two closest user-created railing nodes. If the segment is static, you can change it to associative. This also means that if the element did not coincide with the corresponding segment of its host element, it will be modified to fall on the corresponding host element segment. If a static segment falls between two user-created associative railing nodes, changing it to associative We'll also insert automatic associative railing nodes so that the railing reference line goes around and along the geometry of the host element. These changes can be applied to the clicked segment only, or all segments where available. There is an additional option in the dialog, which is the Flip Segment checkbox. This checkbox applies when the railing has been generated between two user-created nodes of its closed host element geometry. In such cases, the railing reference line can go from one node to the other, either clockwise or counterclockwise. If the Flip Segment checkbox is checked, when you click the OK button in the dialog, the railing reference line switches from clockwise to counterclockwise, and vice versa. Please also watch all the other clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the capabilities of the railing tool.